So my study is based on the safety of Rasa Ayurvedic drugs. So we know there is a long history of this Rasa Ayurvedic drug. We all have experienced the therapeutic effect, this wonderful product. But today, since I am not a Ayurvedic practitioner, professional in Ayurvedic, I am a biochemist, so I will be talking about the Rasa drug not as therapeutic, its therapeutic effect, and I will look at as a chemical compound, xenobiotic, which we introduce to our body as a drug. So either in Western medicine, in Ayurvedic medicine, whatever the drug that we are talking, it is a xenobiotic, foreign product, foreign body to our body. So I will forget about the therapeutic effect, but I will talk about the safety of this drug as a biochemist. So because all the respected speakers were talking, discussing the therapeutic effect, so this is a bit different. So I'm not going to talk about the history, so we all know about it, the audience. Now, why? Now, first of all, so this is study done with the Navina Ayurveda Research Institute. It is a collaborative work. So it is a study with Dr. Vatsala Vijayasinghe. I don't know whether she is here. Yes, Dr. Vatsala Vijayasinghe, Professor Ranaveera. So as a group, we did this. First of all, I would thankful for all our group to giving this opportunity to engage this such a wonderful work. Now, the reason of this, the purpose of this study is we selected this the Rasa drug because of the presence of metal there, the metal, because there are now certain myths regarding the metal of this Rasa drug. Especially in our country, the problem of the CKD, unknown chronic kidney disease, because there are certain myths regarding this metal of this drug also can be an etiological factor. So therefore, we decided it's better if we do this, whether if we can investigate the safety of this drug when we introduce to the living body. Now, metal. So I will look at a metal from the biochemistry point of view. We know metal has a lot of advantages in our body. They have a lot of biological functions. So therefore, I guess whether the reason of introducing this metal in this Rasa drug, is it this wonderful biochemical effect that we have seen them when it is functioning in our living body? Okay. Now, the most important thing is this: the biochemical effect that we expect from this metal, it is at lower levels. So almost all these metals that we are talking in this Rasa drug, so maybe at lower levels, so they do several functions in our body, especially at enzyme level. So when they are in the enzyme, the proteins, when they are with the proteins, so they promote, facilitate the enzyme action. And there is a risk when the level is little bit higher than the expected level, they can do certain damage, lethal effect to our body, especially the cellular damage. So we have to look at the safety of Rasa drug on these two extremes. At lower levels, there are a lot of advantages, but there is a risk, that is, if the metal are at higher levels. So here I am talking about the metal only. Okay, as a biochemist, I will look at the metal. I am not talking about the metal in rasa drug. So what are the biological function of metal in our body? So one of the important, the disadvantage of this is they interfere the antioxidant enzymes. Interference of antioxidant enzymes, so they can give rise to a lot of diseases like stroke, heart attack. So there are so many diseases that we get as a result of this oxidative damage. Alteration of thiol protein, that is, thiol is sulfur, so there are proteins with containing sulfur, so the metal can alter, change the biological function of this protein. And the other thing is in the energy metabolism. In one aspect, these metals, they have very promoting stimulatory effect on the energy metabolism, but sometimes it can interfere with our energy metabolism. And finally, the alteration of DNA structure. So that is, sometimes it is an advantage. This metal can do gene expression. They can promote, induce gene expression, and also some damage to the DNA. So these are the biological functions of metal. So now when it comes to the cellular damage, that is the disadvantage at higher level, what are the expected toxic effects? So kidney is a major organ which excrete all these metals from the body. So therefore we expect toxic effects mainly for the kidney, since it is the organ which get exposed finally for all these metals. So therefore this is the place where we think of the CKD and the metal, and some talk about the rasa drug as well. And metal binding proteins are there in the membrane, so once they bind, sometimes it will change the membrane function. And the receptors in the proteins, which are very sensitive for the external environment, so they can change, the metal can change all these functions. The renal tubule, in the kidney, the kidney tubule, so these cells play a very important role in excretion of some unwanted product. So sometimes this metal can change all these and risk for a cancer. So these are the expected cellular damage when the metal are found at higher levels. Now, having all these in our mind, so we investigated these four rasa drugs, the safety of these four drugs. The Mutunja, Buddharaja, Ajirakshara, Sitarambati. So I heard several speakers, they were talking some of the drugs. Now, I am not, as I said at the beginning, I am not going to talk about the therapeutic effect much. So I learned from Dr. Vatsala and our friends there, the therapeutic effect of all these drugs. And we found the expected, the minerals that we get in all these. So I have listed here the sulfur, potassium, arsenic, so all these. So mercury is there. Mercury, actually we consider mercury as a very, very toxic metal. It can damage a lot of membrane proteins. So we found that this mercury is also there, but we don't know this mercury, even though we are afraid of this mercury as a toxic metal, but when it is in these drugs, how it, the play role played by Mercury when it is in the Rasa Tak, we don't know. So the objectives, investigation of toxicity. So here we thought, if these Rasa drugs, so the title is safety, so the extreme in whether these Rasa drugs can cause any toxicity. So we, our hypothesis was whether these Rasa drugs, the metal in these drugs, whether they can produce any toxicity to liver and kidney. So we investigated from the biochemical point of view. And we selected as two levels, the acute and chronic, for short term and the long term. Actually, now when we talk about this acute and chronic, I learned from the Ayurvedic physician, from Dr. Vatsala and other of my friends, because they have the practice of limiting the time period of when they are using the Rasa drug for treatment. They don't use it for a longer time period. Okay? So therefore, for the chronic toxicity, I didn't take it for a longer time period because I knew that they are not using it for a longer time. So acute and chronic, it is chronic, I took it as 24 days. And so we wanted to check, investigate the if there are any toxicity by the serological changes, whether it changes any the protein, the serum proteins, enzymes, and whether they change the structure, histopathological structure of major organs, we hear liver and kidney. So this is first, it is an animal experiment. So we used mice, 8 to 12 weeks mice. So I am not going to describe much detail. It is, so we grouped them. And we considered the human dose that for each drug that are given for human, and we converted it for based on the animal that we are using, mice, we converted into the respective dose for these animal. And with the what I learned from the group, so we prepared all these immediately before the administration. And the doses that we use, we had a control group because we wanted to mimic the stress that the animal get exposed. So we had the control group with distilled water, and half dose, half of the dose, the normal dose, and the double dose. Because according to my experience, not like Western, no, I'm not talking about all, but not like Western medicine, people, they don't much concern about the dose. This is my experience. I may be wrong, because they don't pay much attention about the dose for the Ayurvedic drugs. So therefore, we thought it is good if we do the double dose as well. So we treated the control, half dose, normal dose, and the double dose. So all together, there are four groups. So this is how we did the trial. Now, with the 14 days, we sacrificed animals and we did the histopathological studies of liver and kidney, and also we took we collected blood and serum to see whether any changes of the serum with respect to the toxicity. And these are the biochemical parameters we did. Serum, that is regarding the renal function test, we wanted to see whether it is affected for the kidney, the serum urea, creatinine, and electrolytes, sodium and potassium level in the blood. For the liver function, we did transaminases, the aspartate aminotransferases, alanine aminotransferases, and the total serum protein. The reason is we know the liver is the organ responsible for the synthesis of the plasma protein, So if we measure the total plasma protein level, it is an indication about the liver function. So if there is a liver failure, we may expect low level because of the liver failure. This transferases. So these transferases, we do not find a higher level in the serum. These are non-functional enzyme. In biochemistry we say plasma non-functional enzyme. They do not have a specific function in the plasma, but as a result of cell damage for the hepatic cell, liver cell, this enzyme comes out, and the elevated level of this enzyme level in the plasma indicate a damage for the liver cell or death. And we did the histopathological studies. So I have to thank Dr. Roshita Waduge of our faculty. She did all these pathological studies, and we took the kidney, liver, and all these this procedure that is done for the histopathology. And the results. Okay, so these are the results. Now, by looking at the graph, we can see that there is no much difference between the acute and the chronic level compared to the normal. So we do not see any elevation of change of the transferases, protein, sodium, potassium, urea, creatinine. That is, according to our results, the serological changes, it is not significant. It is not significant. They did not show any toxic effect with respect to the serological changes for all the Rasa drugs that we did. Same for the Buddha Raja, Vajraksara, and Sitara. So it was very clear that the serological changes were not significant. But when we look at the histopathological, we could see certain. I'm sorry that you can't read it. So we could see some of the liver, kidney changes with the double dose, especially for Murtunja. With the higher dose, they show certain necrosis, little bit degenerative changes in the liver and kidney. It is only for Murtunja with the double dose. So our conclusion, so when we consider the Murtunja So if it is recommended, if it, we use higher doses than the recommended doses, so it can cause some liver and kidney damage that is long term. But for the serological changes, it is, we couldn't see any significant changes. So final conclusion. So with this study, I repeated this study. I did it for two times. So we got the same results. So we can say it is very safe to use this drug for 24 days. It did not cause any toxic effect. So in animals, so we expect the same in human because based on the dose that we used. So this is this conclude my study, and again I would be thankful to the organizing committee for considering me as a speaker for this great event, and I consider this is a proud for me. And again I would thankful to Dr. Vatsala Vijayasinghe, Professor Ranaveera, for having this allowing me to engage this. It's very new for me, so we were maybe more than 2 years we have been engaging this work. Still we are continuing, so we are getting very interesting results. So I hope to present this maybe the next conference. Thank you very much.